to the fullest, but still I'm needed. Yeah, what's really happening?
We've known each other for a long time. We grew up together. Now we've hit the refresh button. You tap and we bring the coffee that makes your day. And not just that, but your groceries. Yeah, we deliver that now too. Whatever you need, we're right there every single day. Done. Talabat, your everyday right away.
Life to the fullest, but still I'm needed.
We've known each other for a long time. We grew up together. Now we've hit the refresh button. You tap and we bring the coffee that makes your day. And not just that, but your groceries. Yeah, we deliver that now too. Whatever you need, we're right there every single day. Done. Talabat, your everyday right away.
to the fullest, but still I'm needing. Yeah, what's really happening?
We've known each other for a long time. We grew up together. Now we've hit the refresh button. You tap and we bring the coffee that makes your day. And not just that, but your groceries. Yeah, we deliver that now too. Whatever you need, we're right there every single day. Done. Talabat, your everyday right away.
Living life to the fullest, but still I'm needing.
yeah, what's really happening?
We've known each other for a long time. We grew up together. Now we've hit the refresh button. You tap and we bring the coffee that makes your day. And not just that, but your groceries. Yeah, we deliver that now too. Whatever you need, we're right there every single day. Done. Talabat, your every day, right away.
Life to the fullest, but still I'm needing.
Yeah, what's really happening?
We've known each other for a long time. We grew up together. Now we've hit the refresh button. You tap and we bring the coffee that makes your day. And not just that, but your groceries. Yeah, we deliver that now too. Whatever you need, we're right there every single day. Done. Talabat, your everyday right away.
life to the fullest, but still I'm needing.
Yeah, what's really happening?
We've known each other for a long time. We grew up together. Now we've hit the refresh button. You tap and we bring the coffee that makes your day. And not just that, but your groceries. Yeah, we deliver that now too. Whatever you need, we're right there every single day. Done. Talabat, your everyday right away.
Seeker. He dares the adventure of beauty in all its singularities, the very singularities of his indisciplined hero. It's all about individuality, innocence, pride. It's about setting the tone of life from now and tomorrow. Because a dandy has attitudes and values at the core of his garment. Be it modernity, progress towards the future. Much greater. It's a line that defines the style tribe, making him and her desirable in a radical change. Being themselves, mingling. Valid is disobedience of elegance when dandy becomes trendy.
Life to the fullest, but still I'm needing.
Yeah, what's really happening?
We've known each other for a long time. We grew up together. Now we've hit the refresh button. You tap and we bring the coffee that makes your day. And not just that, but your groceries. Yeah, we deliver that now too. Whatever you need, we're right there every single day. Done. Talabat, your everyday right away.
life to the fullest, but still I'm needing.
Yeah, what's really happening?
We've known each other for a long time. We grew up together. Now we've hit the refresh button. You tap and we bring the coffee that makes your day. And not just that, but your groceries. Yeah, we deliver that now too. Whatever you need, we're right there every single day. Done. Talabat, your everyday right away.
Very good, and I'm very happy today, especially that I'm hosting you on the Council's Talk.
I'm happy to be here, and I'm flattered to be here.
Thank you so much. So, Leanne, I just wanted everyone who's watching us today to know that when I was just starting the fashion journey, and I always used to see you on every single important fashion show, and your presence, your figure, was what created the vibes of the fashion week, of the blogging scene and everything. It's like such an impressive character you are.
Wow, I'm speechless.
You have been one of the very important figures globally to define the meaning of credible blogging. What made Leanne Pernet a success story, in your opinion?
You know, it's funny, like how the whole blog started. What's really funny is, do you follow on Instagram Imran, B-O-F?
Mm-hmm.
He just posted yesterday these pictures on the beginning. Well, it wasn't exactly my beginning because I started 2005 with the blog. I think he started B-O-F 2007, Susie Bubble, I think 2006. Three of us together and Brian Boy, like old pictures from, you know, back then. Were like, I guess it was 2007 or something. They just, over Christmas, he put all these things together. How it started with the blog, well, I used to write for something called Disciple Films. We used to make films like Festival Vierre, just to record like the event for Villeneuve. And then one day, when we were in Milan, actually, and we were going to the shows and also visiting showrooms. And one of the showrooms, I can't remember the designer, but he had this model called Anina. And she was doing a great job. Like she really, you know, assumed the clothes she was wearing. And then I think she had kind of a crush on the guy that I was working with, who was 27, cute guy, and she came to Paris and saw him, and we were working together, and she was like really into technology, and she asked me, this is 2005, when Nokia, do you remember Nokia?
Yeah, I remember.
Like a blue brick.
Oh my God.
I mean, it's a really long time ago. Before YouTube, I think YouTube maybe starts around the same time. Not yet, though. I don't think it started in 2005. But anyway, she said, would you be up for trying? Because I'd been working with my digital camera, making movies and stuff. She said, would you like to try something called life blogging? That's before Twitter. So I with a Nokia phone. And SFR, which was the carrier, had no clue what was going on. Like if you had a problem, because my first assignment was, do you remember the brand Iri Kishimoto?
Mm-hmm.
Like half Japanese, half British. Uh-huh. They were launching a menswear collection with the Gumball Rally. I should send you the link. You'd laugh if you see this. It's really the beginning of blogging. It's 2005. And she said, okay, you want to try this life blogging? So when we'd have a problem, and there was always a problem, because we were going from Trafalgar Square to Monte Carlo, and she'd have to call Nokia in Finland to, because nobody knew. It was totally new beta form technology. Anyway, I attribute Anina to the beginning of my blogging. And it'd be funny because I'd go to the shows and, you know, like Sid Idris or whatever, and you're waiting. And I'd be doing this live blogging. So I would shoot whatever, talking, and it would be immediately uploaded onto my blog. And I remember talking to Terry Jones from ID. He's like, what is that? You know, it was totally new and fun. And I like doing things that are kind of cutting your own way. And that's kind of how it started, I mean, with Anina. And it's like 16 years now, the blog, in a couple weeks. Can you imagine?
Congratulations. Diane, what is different in what Diane Perner writes? Is it the style, the critic? Like, what makes you different than the others?
I think it's like, you know, like the name of it, A Shaded View on Fashion. It's kind of double entendre, you know, shades, okay. But I write about the people that interest me. And if I don't like them, I don't cover them, but I don't trash people. I'm not into being bitchy, you know, it's not my style. So I think it's curiosity. It's really curiosity and what I like. And what I like is people that have their own voice, somebody that's creative. But within that, there's a huge, you know, panoply of choices.
Of course, to be continued.
Life to the fullest, but still I'm needed. Yeah, what's really happening?
Davantage de départements en couvre-feu, c'est Jean Castex qui se chargera des annonces en fin d'après-midi.
At least 78 people dead and 4,000 injured in a huge explosion.
Une ville bat tous les records, c'est Roubaix avec 1135 nouveaux cas pour 100 000 habitants.
Well, since July, many animals have also been killed as forests have been destroyed by the flood.
Diane, you started a shade of new on fashion, which we call it ASVOF, whoever wants to check it out. Could you please tell us more about it?
Like I said, I started writing for Disciple Films. It used to be called Diane's Diaries. When I was starting filming, someone got me editing, like Final Cut Pro, because I was shooting, never editing. And the guy that got me the Final Cut Pro, he got tired of me asking him questions all the time. So he said there's a site called, and I forget what it was called, but for Final Cut Pro users. And it was someone somewhere in the world will be able at any time will be able to answer your questions, like basically don't ask me anymore. And so I went on this site and I saw this guy. This was the beginning of my, he was the beginning of my editing film, which I'm not really editing it anymore. But how we met Anina, the blogging, how it all, it's a circle. So anyway, I went on this site because I was having problems. The film and the camera, the tape was getting all jammed. I couldn't even start the editing process. And the guy goes, I see one guy says he's in Paris. So I thought, okay, but he had a question, a rather strange question, like, how do you block out somebody's eyes? And I thought, oh God, it could be pornography, who knows? But I'll take a chance and contact this guy and see if he could spend like a half an hour and just show me something. So I arrive, so the guy goes, well, do you have a portable computer? Just come over and, I'll help you. So I was a little bit nervous. But I thought, okay, and he's in the 16th and I'm in the 7th, it's not that far. So I went and it was this cute young guy who's was shooting films, but more like business things. But he loved fashion and actually his best friend was going with the girl that designed jewelry for Chanel. So he was always at the shows loving fashion. So he goes, okay, let's do something together. I wanted to get into fashion. So we started working together. And and I wrote for him. He had a website at the time called Disciple Films. And I was like the fashion arm of it. It was like three of us, like three guys, two guys at 27 years old and me, not 27. And we did something really funny. I should send you the links. We got commissioned by Gallery Lafayette to do Paris. First it was to do Paris. And within the first day of shooting, I thought, the guy that used to work with Karl Lagerfeld, I'm forgetting his name now. Jill Dufour. He had just been pushed out of Chanel for Amanda Harlick, when Lagerfeld was kind of competing with Galliano. And so I thought, okay, I will give him some coverage, put him in the window of Gallery Lafayette. So I went to him and they said, because Andre, the graffiti artist, mm-hmm. also has all the clubs in Paris and Hotel Amour and stuff. He had done like the pictures for him. There weren't really clothes for the collection. So I said to Jill Dufour, this is really the beginning of the blog. Could I do a little soundbite of you on your collection? He goes, come back at 6 o'clock and I'll give you the interview with Catherine Deneuve. Catherine Deneuve, because of course he knows her from Chanel. So can you imagine Gallery Lafayette? The next day in the window, because the way we worked from like 9 a.m. till 3 a.m. And when I do the voiceover for the films, like at 3 a.m. And then the guys would like edit and get it in the window at 9 a.m. at Gallery Lafayette. It was like on Boulevard Haussmann. So when Gallery Lafayette saw Catherine Deneuve in their window, They were literally kissing my feet. It was great. I mean, that was kind of the beginning of, you know, I worked 5 years with Alex Tepertinsky. That was his name, is his name. And then with Anina, she told me to try that Nokia phone. And that's when I started the blog, and that's how it all kind of began.
Wow.
And then 1 year later, I decided to do my fashion film festival.
Wow. It's as if you were having this kind of feeling that probably the fashion industry is going to go into this digital experience which we're living in now. Like having attending almost all the fashion shows the traditional way, and now you're experiencing the digital fashion week. How do you see this compared to the fashion film festival which you started?
Well, for me, it's great. You know, you sit here, you can watch everything, because normally on Fashion Week, you really have to, you can't see everything. It's just not possible.
Not possible.
So here you can, and you can re-see it. And I've seen, you know, because I've covered fashion for, I moved to Paris the end of 1990. Before that, I was creating, I was doing my own shows. So I only went to shows of my friends. But so I've been attending all the shows from like 1991. I've seen almost everything. I think I've seen everybody at one point or another. And so I'm not missing sitting in the shows so much. I know lots of people are, but me, I'm thinking, this is great. You know, it's also like going to a film festival and you see, okay, well, that film is quite interesting. I'm going to call that in. You know, it's like, I personally love it. I think, you know, it allows, like, I know you were mentioning in your questions, does it push people's creativity? And I think some people it really does, and they come up with brilliant things. And others, they're just lost, you know? They should come to me as a consultant and put them together with a good director to create something. Because I think when you're just doing catwalk on, you know, digital, it's not so interesting. Actually, there are a few times when it works, like today with Valentino, it's basically a catwalk show, but it worked. You know, it was beautiful. Even Chanel today, which I'm not a huge fan of, and it was just a catwalk, but it worked. And sometimes I remember last season, Angel Chen, she did in China, in Shanghai, she did a catwalk, but it was with very digital, where there's a lot of gaming things now, yeah. Or like this season, Tom Brown was so fun with the kids. And last season, you did a great film. Or Phipps did a great film. You know, it's cinema. I personally prefer designers when they hook up with great directors and come up with a film, you know. It's because I like cinema. So, I mean, if it's just a catwalk, I don't see it as something that I'm going to look for my festival, because that's just, well, Kids Super did a catwalk with dolls, so that worked, and that won the grand prize last year. But generally, just people walking up and down the catwalk is it
just deja vu? Basically, what impressed you and what designers have been able to showcase in the format of the fashion film since the start of the pandemic? Obviously not the models walking down the runway, like you, I assume you're looking into more creativity and into more how transformation of a brand.
Yeah, I mean, well, there are certain brands that are always great with fashion films, such as Gucci, Saint Laurent. Of course, they have big budgets, you know, so it's easier for them. But that's not really necessary, because look at someone like Phoebe Magoo, you know, the guy from South Africa that won the LVMH prize a couple years ago. He did a great film on surveillance, which probably cost not much. It was really lo-fi, but it was great, and you remember it. And like I already mentioned, Tom Brown is great. And I thought for Martin Margiela last year, Show Studio with John Galliano, it was interesting because you mixed the process with, you know, fantasy of tango and whatever. And I thought it really worked. I don't know. I mean, if you're going to show somebody like just sketching, I don't think it's that interesting. Or dancing around their showroom. It's like I just saw one of the films. I'm not going to mention the name. I just thought it was like, I don't know. Also, Kenzo has always made good films. They always are creative with choice of directors. Prada, always, you know, because they really choose directors out of the box, not necessarily the biggest names. And Dior made a beautiful film, the same director, Garoni, like they did last season. But I mean, that's a big budget, but you don't need a big budget to make a great film. You need an idea. That's what you need. And
so you're saying about the big budgets and about the big names, the giants able to produce a very impressive fashion film is not surprising to us. However, seeing young emerging designers that their budgets are really still at the beginning, being able to do short movies and compete with the giants is really impressive to us and heartwarming. How do you see that this digital experience is kind of creating a neutral ground for the young designers to be able to create something as beautiful as the giants?
It does. It's really democratic now because we are all sitting in front of our screens. And if you're serious enough about being a journalist or, you know, if you have any curiosity, you can watch everything. And so you're giving as much attention to someone perhaps you never heard of, or, you know, maybe like a journalist, like, I don't know, someone who's only, you know, their schedule only had them covering the brands that advertise in their magazine has never seen this small designer. Well, now they can, you know, and like brands like GmbH, you know, in Berlin, they do great things, and I'm sure they're not spending buckets of money on a film. I don't think, you know, Vetements, it was interesting, it really wasn't a film, a lookbook, basically, but they were dynamic enough that it worked. It was interesting also today with Valentino, because he did like the catwalk, and then under it, they had the whole description of the clothes, which I think is getting more commonplace because I saw it in something else these past couple days. But I think it's just have an idea and just go and create it and don't think about money, because the best equipment in the world and the most biggest budget doesn't make a great film. And I can attest, like with my jury, and I always have a great jury, the grand prize winner is usually someone no one ever heard of, you know, because they did a great film. And that's what caught everybody's attention. And it has nothing to do with budgets. I think people have to understand it's if you have an idea or some message, you know, you want to transmit by visually, that's what makes a good film. It's nothing to do with money.
That's very motivating for the young brands. Diane, what advice would you give to all the emerging brands watching us today who would really want to be out of the box and catch the attention of people like you?
Well, you know, there's the submissions are open now and they have till the end of July, so you should go to my, I have a new Instagram for the festival that asva_official. But just like create something that's authentic, you know, that means something to you, whether it's, you know, creating a film that takes you back to your family having breakfast, you know, it doesn't matter. Just make your own story. It's storytelling, but make it personal. I think everybody is an individual and everybody sees life differently. I mean, we're all, you know, a head, two arms, two legs, but I think be personal and have it mean something to you. Because if it means something to you, it has a soul. And if it has a soul, then we can feel it. And for me, I look at films and it's what touches me.
True.
You know, is what's going to get in. And you can tell something that's fake and something that's authentic. It doesn't take, you know, any extreme talent to be able to feel things, you know.
True, absolutely. So personal stories, they are always touchy. Well, Diane, I can sit and chat with you for hours, and we can all be live and watching this amazing, beautiful legend story, Diane Pernet. I would really love to thank you for your presence with us on the Council Talk today, and looking forward to an amazing Passion Film Festival.
And thank you for inviting me.
So much. Do the best. To be continued.
Okay. Take good care.
Take care. Bye.
To the fullest, but still I'm needed. Yeah, what's really happening?
We've known each other for a long time. We grew up together. Now we've hit the refresh button. You tap and we bring the coffee that makes your day. And not just that, but your groceries. Yeah, we deliver that now too. Whatever you need, we're right there every single day. Done. Talabat, your everyday right away.